Hello everybody. We are beginning with your, this is my cartoon, drawn by a well-known cartoonist, Mr. Sanjay Mistry. And he just visited our class and he said that I want to draw your cartoon. So I said, all right, this is caricature actually, they are saying. So it will be there with me now. And you can compare also. Now, we are starting out our discussion about paper 2, that is there in comprehension style. Now, what is exactly I want to tell you, because say, English is not my mother tongue, and I'm not that fluent in English. I can understand the concept, but while speaking, I'm not that fluent, but still, we are focusing here with the comprehension from UPSC question paper directly, civil services question paper. Now here, before starting out our discussion, I must clarify you certain points regarding comprehension. Say, already we have recorded lectures of English where Madam Nisha Oza is there. Actually, we discussed that in lecture about grammar, the grammatical part, that is not directly useful for civil services examination, but that is essential part, so we discussed that. But if you are going for CDS or NDA like exam, then this grammar portion is also important. Then certain paragraphs we discuss in that lecture. Now this is additional one. Say, what is the interest? When a person is interested in English comprehension, that lectures are all right. But we have, apart from that, some comprehensions. If you are going throughout that question paper, you will get set divided into two parts. The first part that we are calling, that is as English comprehension, and the second part, general comprehension. So in that general comprehension, we have English passage, and side by side we have Hindi translation of that passage. Suppose your mother tongue is Hindi, or your education is there in Hindi language, or you are having fluency in Hindi language, you have option that you can go by Hindi paragraph also. Very unfortunate to say, but I am not that fluent in Hindi, and everybody in India unfortunately is not that fluent in Hindi, and therefore we are discussing this part in English. So in case of comprehension, you have to consider two parts. The one part where comprehension skill is required, where you have passage in English as well as Hindi translation, and in second part we have English passage only and no Hindi translation is provided for that. But that is an easier passage somewhat. We have to discuss step by step. So I am discussing the passage from question paper, UPSC question paper, that is there in civil services examination from 2011. From that exam we have question paper. You can download that question paper from upsc.gov.in. Whereas what is my suggestion, that answer key is also available on the site. You can download that, but only mere say this is question and this is answer is not good one. So we have to discuss why this is so. Let us check out. We have answer question paper. First in theoretical discussion I have to carry out, that in case of comprehension, many questions are complicated in nature. Sometimes we are having clear that idea, that out of four options, that whatever options given, one is correct and all three other are wrong. But sometimes we have the idea that maybe possible two options are likely correct. Sometimes we feel that four options are correct, and at that time we had to choose different method. So here it is not at all required that you should have word to word meaning of the words. Many times some high class words are also used. we have to guess the meaning, not exact meaning is expected. What is the thing that moral of passage you should able to know, and we can extract something from that passage. Okay, so we are focusing and we are discussing side by side, not the thing that entire lecture I am taking first and then we are starting out about paragraph. Now I am starting out with passage 1, that is for question 1. Check out in your question paper. No doubt that you have question paper in your hand, but still my suggestion is that read with me simultaneously. Many students are having habit that okay, directly jump on the questions, but here when we are studying out, keep in mind, don't jump directly on the question. First try to understand the passage, try to develop the understanding skill, and then we are going to discuss questions. Now I am reading out the passage first. No doubt it's time consuming, but still it required. Let us start. For achieving inclusive growth, there is a critical need to rethink the role of the state. What is inclusive growth? We are using many words, say inclusive all. If you are using a certain product, maybe possible it is given there many times that MRP XYZ inclusive of all prices, all the taxes. So like that we are referring out the word. So here, for achievement of inclusive growth, there is a critical need to rethink the role of the state. The early debate among economists about the size of the government can be misleading. The need of the hour is to have an enabling government. Now here important word is there that we are calling as enabling government. Whether it is enabling or unabling, that is also important. So here they are using word enabling. I'm reading further. India is too large and complex a nation for the state to be able to deliver all that is needed. Now, if you are comparing size of India, then obvious thing is that USSR, that was United States of Soviet Russia, and today Russia also is having considerable high size. But population wise, it's having very, very less population. United States of America, still greater in size, area wise, but population less than 1/4 of Indian population. And China, obviously, it's there, our competitor size wise. So they are saying that government, because of its large size and complex nation, for state to able to deliver all that is needed. Now, asking the government to produce all the essential goods, create all the necessary jobs, and keep curb on the prices of all goods is to lead to a large, cumbersome bureaucracy and widespread corruption. So, this is the first passage. Now try to extract something. Say, what is the passage about? By reading out first para or first few line, we can clearly have idea that the passage is something that is about Indian science, Indian democracy, or Indian state and government. So we have to focus on Indian government. We are starting out that some experts are giving some sites where India is having much more different things and conditions are also different. Now, second para, the aim must be to stay with the objective of inclusive growth that was laid down by the founding fathers of the nation, and also to take a more modern view of what the state can realistically deliver. I mean, first para we discussed that government should provide this and that, etc., are usually expected thing. But here, this says the aim must be to stay with the objective of inclusive growth that was laid down by the founding fathers of the nation. And also to take a more modern view of what the state can realistically deliver. See, everything should not be delivered by state. We can deliver, we can produce ourselves also. That is the moral here. And when we started out after freedom from Britishers, if you are a student of history, you will really know that we got freedom many times in the history. So here, from Britishers, after getting freedom from Britishers, whatever our father of nation and that time, they decided that should be fulfilled, as well as they are saying that more modern view of what the state can realistically deliver. This is what leads to the idea of an enabling state. That is, a government that does not try to directly deliver to the citizens everything that they need. That means, let us check out. Say, we are going for many treks. Now, trekking requires planning. Where to go, how to go, what material we should have, whether we are going to prepare food there, or we are carrying out packed lunch, or we are having some dry food items with us. Like that, we are going to decide first. Now it happens that many trekking groups, in that group, somebody is there who organized the trek. He charging out something amount and going to take you for trek. In that trek, your involvement is not there. Your involvement is there with money, that you are paying him some amount of rupees and you are going with him. Then you may demand, okay, now this is the time of breakfast, what is the provision for breakfast? Now this is lunch time, we want lunch, we have packed lunch, or what provision is there. That means we are entirely depending on that fellow. Whereas when we go, usually we involve our participant that we have to go by this way. Do you have any suggestion? Say, in Maharashtra there are many forts, and they are still today, because Britishers destroyed their way, path to go on that hilltop, and many forts are not having any habitat. That means, say, I can't stay over that fort, arrangement is not there, not a single man is there on fort that he will survive, he will supply you something to eat. So we are planning out, and ultimately we decide that, okay, are we going to prepare food over there, or we are consuming dry food, and we are involving people, okay, you can purchase this, you can purchase that, and then we are togetherly going over there. And we are enjoying. So nobody will ask, okay, this is time of breakfast, we want breakfast. No. Because we all are planning together, and everybody is involved in the process. So the person who is having breakfast back with him, he will say, now, okay, this is time for breakfast, let us make some arrangement for breakfast. So like that, something is coming out from the person. So what we do, that actually we can take students directly for trek, but no, the students' involvement is important in that place. We are just giving guideline, and then the students, they are carrying out the further thing. Like that, government should not provide each and everything, but government should give you the opportunity. That is what exactly idea of enabling government. Government is not enabling, government is enabling you
That is the meaning over here. Now here, this is what leads to the idea of an enabling state, that is a government that does not try directly deliver to the citizens everything that they need. Instead, it, number one, creates an enabling ethos for the market so that individual enterprise can flourish and citizens can, for the most part, provide the needs of one another. Second step, it to help those who do not manage to do well for themselves, for there will always be individuals, no matter what the system, who need support and help. Hence, we need a government that when it comes to the market, sets effective incentive compatible rules and remains on the sidelines with minimal interference, and at the same time plays an important role in directly helping the poor by ensuring that they get basic education and health services and receive adequate nutrition and food. This is socialistic approach that we should have this all, particularly for poor. Now, I hope passage is not that difficult. That means English language use here is not that difficult. One or two words are hardly to explain. But otherwise, what is the basic idea? That role of government in development is given here. Now let us check out from the questions. The first question, obviously, we are going to discuss now. There are options four. According to the passage, now keep in mind you have paper with you, but still read with me. The objective of inclusive growth was laid down by the founding fathers of the nation. So what they are mentioning according to the passage. The objective of inclusive growth was laid down by the founding fathers of the nation. Need of the hour is to have an enabling government. The government should engage in maximum interference in the market process. There is a need to change the size of government according to the passage. Now look at the options. Four statements are given. Here I may say that I have to remove unwanted thing, that the government should engage in maximum interference in the market. This is not according to passage. In passage it is clearly mentioned that minimal interference should be there. So three number statement I am removing out. There is need, fourth number statement, there is need to change the size of government. No doubt in first para they are discussing about size of government, but they are not saying that one should decrease that or increase the size of government. And so I may remove fourth statement. Now first statement and second statement, because while reading only I realized that first statement and second statement are true or more correct. Third and fourth symbol that is there in his way, Hindustan, Pakistan. So first statement, the objective of inclusive growth was laid down by the founding father of the nation. Second para, read, the aim must be to stay with the objective of inclusive growth that was laid down by founding fathers of the nation. So statement is matching out, and so first statement is true. Now second statement, need of the hour is to have an enabling government. Yes, go through first para. The need of the hour is to have an enabling government, clearly mentioned over there, and so option must be first and second, both are correct. Check out the option. Option A gives 1 and 2 only. Then option B gives 2 and 3. So 3 is wrong, so I am not able to get option B. C 1 and 4 only, but 4 is also not correct, so I am removing that. D option 1, 2, 3, 4, but as we discussed, 3, 4 are not correct. Whereas 1 and 2, I found their evidence in passage directly. And so, I am considering answer A is the correct answer in this contest. Now second, according to the passage, the strategy of inclusive growth can be effected by focusing on where we have to focus, that we have to find, meeting all needs of every citizen in the country. So I am revising. According to the passage, the strategy of inclusive growth can be effected by focusing on first, meeting all the needs of every citizen in country. Second option, increasing the regulation over the manufacturing sector. Third, controlling the distribution of manufactured goods. And fourth, delivery of the basic services to the deprived section of the society. I am more focused on option B and C here. Go through question. It is clearly mentioned that whatever discussion is there, that should be according to the passage. And if you observe here, the B and C, say increasing the regulation over the manufacturing sector. If this option is correct or not correct, but we don't discuss anything on manufacturing sector over here. And so I must eliminate option B. Controlling the C option, controlling the distribution of manufactured goods may be correct, may be not correct, but this is not discussed in the passage. I am eliminating, because our passage is not at all focused on manufactured goods, that part. And so I have to remove option B and C. No other alternatives are there. So either A should be correct or D should be correct. Go for A. Meeting all needs of every citizen in the country, it is not obviously correct. Because what they are saying, that government should encourage and government should help the poor and needy people. If that is true, then option A is not correct. And nobody, even I will say that suppose Lord Brahma is also entering on earth and saying, okay, whatever your demand, please ask, I will fulfill your demand. So he is also not able to fulfill everybody's every demand. So government will meeting all the needs of every citizen in the country, it's impossible. So as 1, 2, 3 are not correct, we have to go back D. But check out D again. Delivery of the basic services to the deprived classes. Deprived classes means what? Those who are not getting that. So for them, we have to give basic services. Say, suppose somebody is poor. What is our role? That government should educate the poor. And then, that fellow will do something for the nation as well as for himself also. But it is not the way that government should only feed these people. That means collecting taxes from rich class and feeding out these people. No, that is not expected. But basic things should be provided. So deprived classes, that is right answer. So I can confirm this answer by two methods. Number one, what is expected in passage. According to passage, this is right. The words are changed. Here we can get the words they are using as role, government, it is mentioned, plays an important role in directly helping the poor by ensuring that they get basic education and health services and receive adequate nutrition and food. So here poor means we have to consider a deprived section of the society, and these are all basic services that they should get: education, they should get food, adequate nutritious food. So D option is according to passage. And second method we discuss, that elimination method, as B and C by reading only we can able to eliminate. That this is not according to passage, I am eliminating out. Now question is there between A and D, but A is not realistic option and it is not also discussed in passage. So I am eliminating out. So ultimate none of these is not given option. So D must be correct. So by both method, according to passage and according to we are eliminating part, also answer getting is D. Next, what constitutes an enabling government? Now here, total 5 options they are given, and out of that 5 options, we have to select any sequence from 4 options again. First option, a large bureaucracy. I am reading out question. What constitutes an enabling government? So, a large bureaucracy. Go through the statement. They are mentioning that large bureaucracy. But government, asking the government to produce all the essential goods, create all the necessary jobs, and keep curb on prices of all goods is to lead to large cumbersome bureaucracy. This is not meant for enabling government. And so, according to passage, large bureaucracy is not required for enabling government. So, I am just while first reading, because this, we have to discuss 5 options. And in exam, you have very little time. Here, I am discussing out, and therefore we are spending much more time over here. Second, so I am eliminating out option A. Option 1. If 1 is not correct, then obvious thing is that go through options where option A and option D, both the options, they are having 1. As part. So I am eliminating out both A and D immediately. So my answer choice is restricted to B and C. Whereas B is having 4 and 5 and C is having 3, 4, 5. That means I have to now consider the second statement as false only. Because only D option is there to consider all 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 options. So, but still, as we are discussing, I am reading out. Implementation of welfare program through representative. This is also not mentioned in the passage. This type of ideas are not at all discussed in passage. And secondly, if you go through the passage, it is clearly mentioned that government should encourage, but they are not mentioning through representative, etc. And so option 2 is also not there, and obviously it is not there. B and C, 2 is not there. Now question is that whether B or C, let us check out third option. If third option is present, then we have to go by C, and third is wrong, then we have to go by B. Creating an ethos that helps individual enterprise. Go through passage again. You will get option 1 in that, in passage, step 1, it create an enabling ethos for the market so that individual enterprise can flourish. So option C is most likely no, because third option is correct. So, but we have to check whether 4 and 5, they are correct or not. So I have to go by fourth option now.
Otherwise, what will happen? We have to reconsider whether first statement or like that. But initially, we have to fix certain ground for the discussion. Therefore, I have fixed 4 and 5. Touch wood, they must be correct. Let us check out.
Providing resources to those who are underprivileged,
that is the deprived. And so, this is there we are discussing previous question only. So, 4th is correct option and according to passage also.
The 5th one, offering direct help to the poor regarding basic services.
Yes, it is also mentioned.
And so, option 3, 4 and 5 only.
This is the correct option. I am going for option C here.
Next question. Why is the state unable to deliver all that is needed?
Read question carefully. We discuss this part and now we have to give answer.
Why is the state unable to deliver all that is needed?
Number one.
Why is the state unable to deliver all that is needed? Now option one, option statement one, it does not have sufficient bureaucracy. Second, it does not promote inclusive growth. Now, it does not have sufficient bureaucracy and therefore state is unable to deliver all that is needed. But in passage it is only mentioned that it requires huge bureaucracy. We have or we not have, that is not commented. See, go through this line. Government, asking the government to produce all the essential goods, create all the necessary jobs and keep curb on the prices of all goods is to lead to a large cumbersome bureaucracy.
So it is not mentioned that something is with us or not us. Require, you can say that okay, the word require is used, means we don't have that. That is right answer.
But here, this is not only reason that why government is unable to deliver all that what is needed, that it does not have sufficient bureaucracy, is not only result. Second, it does not promote inclusive growth.
No, in passage, it is not at all mentioned that it does not promote inclusive growth.
Rather, the word is there for achieving inclusive growth. There is critical need to reaching the role of the state.
And it is not mentioned that government is not promoting out inclusive growth in the passage. So both options are not correct.
But what is my suggestion here? That option one appears one of the reasons, not all, but one of the reasons I can say yes. But they are saying why is the state unable to deliver all that is needed? It does not have sufficient bureaucracy. So only that is not answered. And therefore we are not considering this statement. And so, option A, that is one only, option B, two only, both options are failed. So both one and two, no. So last option is there, neither one nor two. So here we have to go by the option that is neither one nor two. This is the reason. The last question, what is the essential message being conveyed by the author of the passage?
The objective
of inclusive growth laid down by founding fathers of the nation should be remembered. What is the essential message being conveyed by the author of the passage? So this statement is there in passage, no doubt. But next statement, immediate of that, that statement just try to get. And also to take more modern view of what the state can realistically deliver. So I am eliminating out option A immediately, because not only that is mentioned, the essential message is not only statement 1. So I have to remove that. Option B. The government needs to make available more schools and health services. This is one of the important role of government. But what is the essential message passage is giving? That is not only that government should start out education and hospitals or health services. It is one of the message, but not very, very important. Option C. Government needs to establish markets and industries to meet the needs of poor strata of the society. Clearly mentioned that government should regulate the condition, not involve in all these activities. That government should erect market, establish market, or government should establish industries. That is not mentioned. So if B is correct, all right, otherwise D must be correct. Because many times this happens that something is there, statement is there, but it is not more likely. There is a need to rethink the role of state in achieving inclusive growth. Yes, obviously. What is the expectation from our side by government? That we have to think, that government should encourage and not provide all the essential things. That is the moral of passage. At the same time, it is considering that we have to consider the needy and poor people. They should be provided with basic things, educate them, and then they should get whatever their own by their own efforts, not by efforts of others. So out of option B and option D, what is my suggestion? That apparently say B, the government needs to make available more school and health services, is not a moral or essential message of the passage. Whereas D, there is need to rethink the role of state in achieving inclusive growth, is more correct. And so I have to go by option D over here. So this way we are discussing out the passages. Passage required practice. So there is no art that I can transfer you and you are able to get immediate way of getting answers. We have to carry out this practice. And so after discussing 10 or 15 passages and their questions, you will get idea. Now keep in mind, this passage is in, we discussed, that is not connected with English language. Hindi translation is available, and what is the important thing, that you should get moral of the story, only that is required. Now what is English passage? It's of 10th standard English level. It is there, question number 64. Check out. The following 9 items, questions 64 to 72, are based on 3 passages in English to test comprehension of English language, and therefore these items do not have Hindi version. Read each passage and answer the item that follows. I'm reading out passage. He walked several miles that day but could not get anything to eat or drink, except some dry bread and some water, which he got from the cottagers and farmers.
Who is he? I don't know.
But he walked several miles that day, but could not get anything to eat. Initially, they are saying he could not get anything to eat, and then saying or drink, except some dry bread and some water.
All right. But you'll get the level of English somewhat low as compared to previous passage.
As night fell, he slept under haystack.
Hay means that dry grass.
Haystack, lying in a meadow. He felt frightened at first, for the wind blew awfully over the empty fields. He felt cold and hungry, and was feeling more lonely than he had ever felt before.
If he is sleeping alone on that grassland, just imagine the situation. Everybody will feel more lonely, because alone you are sleeping on grassland in the pile of that hay. So you will get that same feeling.
He, however, soon fell asleep, being much tired with his long walk.
So he was walking for long distance and he was tired, and therefore he was there to sleep.
When he got up next day, he was feeling terribly hungry. So he purchased,
that means he was having money,
he purchased a loaf of bread with a few coins that he had.
That's the passage.
Options, questions. When the night fell, he slept. Where he slept? In the open field.
Yes, it is right answer that he is there in open field.
Under a pile of dry grass, that is stay-hawk, haystack, right?
This is also right. First option is right and second is right. What we can do, which is more correct? Say for example, suppose I am there in some other nation and somebody asks, from where you have come? My answer is very simple, I am from India. So, I am not wrong. But in India, suppose somebody asks, from where you are? I have to say, I am from Maharashtra. That means I am specifying now state. Initially I am specifying my nation. Now I am specifying state. Suppose I am there in Maharashtra, then I have to say that I am from Mumbai. That means I am specifying my city. And like that. So first answer is also correct, but second is more correct than first.
Third, in a farmer's cottage.
No, it is not mentioned anywhere in the passage. And under the tree, that is also not mentioned. So there is question of only A and B. Answer is B.
He soon fell asleep because he was exhausted.
Exhausted means tired.
Last line mentioned that as a being much tired with his long walk. So he was exhausted. That is the right one.
He was all alone. Therefore, he was not feeling sleep. In fact, many times it happens that in case of loneliness, we can't sleep.
So option A is right, B is not correct. Option C, he had not slept for days.
Is this mentioned somewhere in passage? Not. Forget it.
Last, he was very frightened.
Then how will he sleep? And so option A is more correct. Other options are not that good.
66. With reference to the passage, consider the following statement. He was walking through the countryside.
Yes, because whatever the description is there, that meadows, then villages, cottage, haystack, like that. These all give idea that he was walking along countryside. So statement 1 is correct.
The cottagers and farmers gave him enough food so that he could sleep at night without feeling hungry.
No, this is exactly contradictory statement what they have discussed. So option 1 is correct, option 2 is not correct. Option A, that gives me 1 only, B 2 only. So my option is 1, that means option A.
Then both 1 and 2, but 2 is second option is not correct.
And neither one nor two, but first option is correct, that he was walking through the countryside. And so our option is option A.
So this way we have to discuss. So this is about English passage. So we discuss in this part of lecture about general passage, that means with Hindi translation, but we discuss in English only. And second, that is not having Hindi translation. All the questions were there from paper UPSC Civil Services examination held in 2011.